Hello, friends and family of the internet. I want to share with you a horror movie that came out in 1994. It is titled In the Mouth of Madness. It is written and directed by John Carpenter, who I am a huge fan of. And I have to tell you, In the Mouth of Madness is actually the third installment in what was officially or unofficially termed his Armageddon series, with The Thing being the first one and The Prince of Darkness being the second. Now, what I love about In the Mouth of Madness is it is, in very many senses of the word, what would happen if you took a book and turned it into a movie while still holding true to what a book is. And it does, that will only make sense if you watch the movie. It is extremely meta in the way John Carpenter goes about structuring the whole film. And it's creepy. It's eerily creepy. And what I like is there are points of violence in the movie, because understandably it is a horror movie. But a lot of times what he does is he either has the violence off camera, or he gives flashes of it, because he sort of underpins the fact that our imagination is a lot worse than whatever he could put on screen. Which again goes back to the point that this is a visual novel that you're watching. And it really does really well in the movie. Sam Neill is awesome in this movie. I absolutely enjoy watching him in this movie. And it's so funny that he's in this movie while at the same time, not even a year later, he'll be in Jurassic Park. So between 1994 and 1995, Sam Neill really flexed his acting muscles by going from a horror movie to a sci-fi thriller. And it's just, I would say In the Mouth of Madness is one really good movie. If you've yet to watch it, if you've never heard of it, or it's sitting there on the back burner, I strongly recommend you give this little retro gem a watch, because In the Mouth of Madness is probably one of John Carpenter's best movies that he's ever produced.